वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर हिस्ट्री टीचर एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट येट अनदर चैप्टर द रिवर वैली सिविलाइजेशन एंड वी आर गोइंग टू बेसिकली डील अबाउट मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशन। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डील अबाउट द मेन फीचर्स ऑफ द मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशन, द कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द सिविलाइजेशन एंड द लाइफ ऑफ द पीपल एंड हाउ इट डेक्लाइंड। सो पीपल, so let us begin. During the Neolithic age, many civilizations began to arise in different parts of the world. Most of these civilizations flourished during the Bronze Age. So we have dealt in our very first chapter about the four phases, four ages: the Stone Age, the Neolithic, Mesolithic, then the Copper Age or the Chalcolithic Age. And Mesopotamian civilization happens to be one of the oldest civilizations. Okay, so now let us do it in detail. So in that, during that time, during the Neolithic age or the Copper or the Bronze age, what we call it, we have seen that many civilizations were coming forward or were flourishing. So four main cradles of civilization flourished around the valleys of big rivers. We have seen that because the river was a means of transport. Then there was water, cultivation could be done. So this was the time when civilization or near the river banks, the civilizations flourished. These civilizations were called cradles because many of the greatest human achievements that later spread to encompass the world had their beginnings here. From simple villages, the civilization developed into more organized and advanced societies. So earlier they were very simple, and then subsequently slowly it developed into advanced civilizations because they started learning new things, they started discovering new things. So from simple they were turning to be advanced. They developed into urban settlements or modern towns due to availability of surplus food and trade facilities, to the adoption of agriculture as the main occupational activity. So majorly this happened because of agriculture, and agriculture first they were doing it for the supply of the food, and as there was surplus food they started trade, and agriculture turned out to be one of the main occupational activities. The Mesopotamian civilization was the earliest of these cradles of civilization. Like I've told you before, that it happened to be one of the earliest. This fact was discovered in the first quarter of the 20th century. The word Mesopotamia. So now let us know what does the word Mesopotamia means. Why was it called Mesopotamia? So Mesopotamia means land between the rivers. And this civilization is also known as the civilization of Crescent because it covers the fertile land. It is a broad fertile valley between the rivers Tigris and Euphrates in West Asia. These two rivers run parallel to each other. They overflowed their banks and deposited alluvial silt along the lower reaches of the plain during floods. So because it was situated or located in between two rivers, that is River Tigris and River Euphrates, and in West Asia, so between two they were parallel, and between it was the Mesopotamia civilization came up. And because they were situated between two rivers, Tigris and Euphrates, it is called the river of the land of between the rivers. And their banks and deposited, and when this water was overflowing, they deposit lot of alluvial silt, and because of the alluvial silt it became very very fertile. The Mesopotamian civilization flourished during the Bronze Age and Iron Age from about 3500 BC to 600 BC. Many empires rose and fell during the time period in this region. So during the basic, when the Mesopotamian civilization flourished was 3500 BC to 600 BC. And during this time, many empires, they rose and they declined during this period. So very, very important period and very, very important region. Due to this reason, it is also known as cradle and grave of many dynasties. So cradle because they came up and grave because again they declined. So it is also called known as the cradle and grave of many dynasties. Sources, how do we come to know about the Mesopotamian civilization? So we came to know about the Mesopotamian civilizations through archaeological sources such as the ziggurat at Ur, the seals and the literary sources such as the Epic of Gilgamesh. It was the oldest epic in the world. So mark out this, you can be asked a question, what is the oldest epic in the world? So it is the Epic of Gilgamesh and was written in ancient Sumeria. The epic gives a vivid account, means it gives a very elaborate account of the adventures of Gilgamesh and his desire to achieve immortality. So I stop, this is my first video. I stop here, more in the next video. Thank you.